Hi, my name is Crystal, and I am such a slob, but I want to learn how not to be a slob, so I call myself the Deslob student. On this journey of de-slobbing my life, decluttering my life, letting go of things that don't serve me, I am finding myself extremely frustrated today, triggered. Lots of PTSD things coming up for me, but it's a Saturday and I choose to be productive anyway instead of laying in bed, curled up in a ball, crying for my life or what's left of it. I don't want to live in that frame of mind. So let's look at the house. Let's challenge the family to get it back in order. We've been on some family trips. We've pretty much relaxed every weekend, or we've been away every weekend. We have not been a productive family each weekend. And it's been a few weekends that we've been productive. Yes, my whole family is a slob, not just me. And as the matriarch of the family, it is up to me to give it my best effort and lead by example, and maybe they will follow. I asked my son to tidy up the kitchen. He says he's already done it. Let's go see what more we could show him to do. And my daughter is supposed to be cleaning up the dining room, since a lot of her items were in the dining room because she was sorting through what she wanted to keep and donate. And the front room has a lot of donations of both my son and my daughters because they've both been decluttering their rooms lately. So I guess it's not true. It's not like we haven't been productive. I've been helping my children declutter their bedrooms each weekend or once in a while through the week, but it's not cleaning up our main areas, that's for sure. So let's go look at the main areas, and yeah, you'll see what I mean.
Hate the world today. You're so good to me, I know, but I can't change. Tried to tell you, but you look at me like maybe I'm an angel underneath, innocent and sweet. Yesterday I cried. You must have been relieved to see the softer side. I can understand how you'd be so confused. I don't envy you. I'm a little bit of everything. I'll roll into one. I'm a bitch. I'm a lover. I'm a child. I'm a mother. I'm a sinner. I'm a saint. I do not feel ashamed. I'm your hell. I'm your dream. I'm nothing in between. You know you wouldn't want it any other way. So take me as I am. This may mean you'll have to be a stronger man. Rest assured that when I start to make you nervous and I'm going to extremes, tomorrow I will change and today won't mean a thing. I'm a bitch, I'm a lover, I'm a child, I'm a mother, I'm a sinner, I'm a saint. I do not feel ashamed. I'm your hell, I'm your dream. I'm nothing in between. You know you wouldn't want it any other way. Thank you.
a tinky hug right now. And she's making me feel better. I'm in a mad, mad mood. I don't feel like I have autonomy to do what I want. So you see that coffee table from my apartment? It is my choice to donate it. Nobody is telling me to donate it, except Matthew. Matthew doesn't think it goes with this room, and he's kind of right, doesn't. But I didn't feel like getting rid of it at the time. Well, now I'm ready to get rid of it. I'm ready to donate it. So let's donate it. It just gets dusty, and it doesn't go with anything.
And it's just... climbs all over it.
Tinky climbs all over it, and it gets stuff underneath it really easily. And it's just taking up a lot of room in the front room. And we're getting rid of the other coffee table too, the old one. I think we're even going to try to sell that dining room table. But first, we need to take a picture of it and post it online.
2 hours later.
It's been a couple hours and my son made lunch for everybody in the middle of our cleaning thing. And I started to get a headache during lunch, so I laid down and I think I had a nap for about a half an hour, maybe an hour. I don't know how long it's been, but it's been a couple hours since you last saw what the front room and dining room and kitchen looked like. So Matthew and Brooklyn have worked a little bit more on those rooms. And so let's go see what they've done now that my headache's gone and I've woken up from my nap. And then we're going to go school shopping for school clothes. That's good. That is looking way better.
I didn't want to get fur under there. I just slept it an hour ago.
You slept that an hour ago and they already got fur under? Well, they didn't get that much fur under there.
That's still a lot of fur for this week an hour ago.
We're cleaning up after you, Tinky Poo. We're cleaning up after you. Okay, so we cleaned the house enough, and I just emptied my car that was full of stuff, and Matthew and Jim are back there donating the back of the truck full of stuff, and we're gonna go school shopping now. Righty Aphrodite, Brooklyn's got her hair all done, you look so cute. You wanna go to this store, Brooklyn? Do you wanna go to this store and shop in here?
No.
I need to go home.
Okay. I'll beat you there. All right. I'll probably just take one car to go shopping. Just because it's kind of silly to drive two cars to go school shopping. All right, so we're gonna end this video and say bye. Say bye.
Bye.
I'd like to end this video with a big thank you, not just to you as the viewer, but also to my friend, Melinda. I would even go as far as to say she's my best friend, my best internet friend, Melinda. Melinda, I am finally wearing my mint green butterfly earrings. Thank you so much for them. They're so pretty. All right, we are back at the house. I just want to be alone for a little bit. I love to be alone. I miss being alone. Okay, that's all. Thanks again for watching, and I will talk to you later. Bye!